impedance matching circuit. We will design an impedance matching circuit, right? To do transformation from one impedance to another impedance, right? So before that, we need to know what are the types of impedance matching circuits you can design, right? So I'll just draw impedance matching circuits. What is this gate? What is this gate? Okay, what is this gate? What is this fellow? What this fellow is called as? L circuits. This fellow is called as? L circuits. Both these gates. I'm sorry. What is this gate? What is this gate? This is C circuits, is it not? What is this gate? What is this gate? LC circuits. My question is it a low pass LC circuit or high pass LC circuit? Low pass or high pass?
Low pass.
Why you call this a slow pass? Whenever you put a capacitor and you ground it, you call it a slow pass. Why do you call it a slow pass? Yes? It grounds the higher frequencies. Why is grounding the higher frequencies? Why is it grounding the higher frequencies? Yes? X is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC. In that case, L will also ground higher frequencies. L and C are same. What is the formula? Why is it you are calling it as a low pass filter? Why is it a low pass filter? I have given you the answer also. What is XC? What is XC? 1 over J omega C. Am I right? Yes or no? So what is this XC? Reactance. And this is 1 over minus 1 over J omega C or J omega C. Which is right? 1 over J omega C. Right? 1 over J omega C. Notice it here. What is F and reactance? Inversely proportional or directly proportional? Inversely proportional. At high frequencies, what happens to reactance XC? Will it be low or will it be high? It will be low. At high frequencies, reactance will be low. Suppose if I give a high frequency signal here, what will be the reactance of this fellow? Low or high?
Low.
So it is low, you know what will happen? All the high frequency signals will get grounded. Suppose if I send a low frequency signal here. What will happen to this capacitance value? It will become high. If I send a low frequency signal here, this reactance value will become high. So it cannot enter, the signal cannot enter, all the signal will be going through this. So this is a low pass filter. This is what? Low pass filter. Okay, you understand or not? Yes? If you do this one, what is this guy called? This way is called? High pass filter, am I right? Why is it called high pass filter? What is XL? J omega L. XL is J omega L, right? So if XL is J omega L, what happens? F and reactions are directly proportional. proportional, right? FN reactants are frequency and reactants are directly proportional. If I give a low high frequency signal, if I give a high frequency signal here, what will be the reactance of this capacitance? Low or high? If I give a high frequency signal, what will be the capacitance of this one?
Low.
Will it be low or high?
Low.
So will the signal pass through it or not?
Yes.
It will pass through it. Yes or no? Now it is coming here. What is the reactance of this bulb? Is it high or low?
High.
Is it high or low?
High.
Can it come through this bulb? Can it come through this bulb? So what will happen? It will go like this. It will go like this. Yes or no? Right. Suppose if I send a low frequency filter, low frequency signal. If I send a low frequency signal, what will be the reactance of this bulb? High or low?
Low.
Low or high?
Low.
Low. So what happened to the signal? The signal will get grounded. The signal will get grounded. So this filter is called, what is this filter? High pass filter or low pass filter? This is a high pass filter. And this guy is a low pass filter. Right? So whenever you have a capacitance which is grounded, it means all your high frequency signals will get grounded. Your high frequency signals will get grounded. That's why we call it as a what filter? Low pass or high pass filter?
Low pass
filter. Right. So today, these are the different types of LC combinations that are possible. These are the different types of LC combinations that are possible. We will be using only two combinations. What are the two combinations? I will use only low pass filter design. And we will design all the impedance matching. Whatever possible impedance matching we want to achieve, we will use only these two circuits and solve our problems. We will be using only these two circuits and solve all our problems. Is it okay? Make a note of it. So connect 50 ohms to 200 ohms load. 50 ohms to 200 ohms at, you need resonant frequency, right? At 2.4 gigahertz. At 2.4 gigahertz. Right? So, I told you, we'll be using only one type of circuit. What is that? Low frequency circuits. Low pass filter circuits. We'll use only low pass filter circuits to design our impedance matching network. Now what is the transformation from 50 ohms to 200 ohms? Is it upward transformation or downward transformation? Is it upward transformation or downward transformation? First thing is, it is upward transformation. So if I have an upward transformation, I will need to select a circuit. The first step is, step one is select the circuit. I will select a C C L circuit. I will select a C L circuit. Sariya, when you see a beautiful girl, what will happen? Pathala oru alagana ponna paathona enna hero ku enna varum? Love. It's called love at first sight, right? It's called love at first sight. Sariya, so when you see a beautiful girl, you'll get love at first sight, right? So upward transformation appadina use a CL circuit. Upward transformation, you will get a CL circuit. Right? If your dad sees you with a beautiful girl, what will happen? Yes or no? So, if your dad sees you with a beautiful girl, what will happen? Yes? Use an LC circuit. It will be an LC circuit. So when you have an upward transformation, what should you use? You will use a CL circuit. And when you have a downward transformation, you will use a LC circuit. Very, very important thing. Sariya, this is the first step you will have to do, right? First thing what you should do, you should find out whether it's upward transformation or downward transformation. If it's upward transformation, what type of circuit you will select? C, L circuit. Right? Love at first sight. So you will, when you see the beautiful girl, you get love at first sight. So C, L circuit you will be choosing. This is the first step. Now, listen here. This is the first step. The second step is, listen here, pay a lot of attention. Pay a lot of attention. This is 50 ohms. And this is 200 ohms. This is 50 ohms. And this is 200 ohms. Now tell me, which is in series, which is in parallel? Which is RS and which is RP? Okay, I'll just write down. Step 2 is identify RP and RS. Tell me, we have identified Q is equal to root of RP by RS. Am I right? Yes or no? Q is equal to RP by RS minus 1. Great. Just look at this circuit. Is these two photos in series or in parallel?
Series.
You just look at it, you will find out this photo is in series. So what is RP? 50 ohms. And what is RS? 200 ohms. That's going to be 200 ohms. So yeah, but looking at this, can you tell it is, which is RP? Take yes or no? Oh, I'm sorry. RS is 50 ohms. And what is RP? 200 ohms. Looking at this photo, you can tell these two photos are in
series.
So what is RS? 50 ohms. Naturally, RP will be 200 ohms. You all agree with me? Yes or no? Right. So this is the step, second step we need to find out. And once you find out RS and RP, you can find out the quality factor Q. Once you find out RS and RP, you can find out the quality factor Q. This is your second step. Is it okay? Right. Now, this is step 2. Next step is step 3. Convert this fellow into a parallel circuit. This fellow is in series, right? So you convert it into a parallel circuit. I'm going to redraw the circuit. Now, I have RP. I have RP. I have Q. Can you find out LP? What is the formula? This is a parallel circuit. This is a parallel circuit. What is the Q of a parallel circuit? What is the Q of a parallel circuit? Q is equal to RP by omega naught LP. RP by omega naught LP. Omega naught, can you find out? It is 2 by F. I have UDF, so it is available. LP, we need to find out. So I have RP and I also have Q. So what will be LP? LP is equal to RP by omega naught Q. Now I found out LP. Now I found out LP. Next, wait. Next is step 4. Step 4. Go back to the old circuit. What is this? L. You would have calculated L. Yes or no? Yes or no? We have calculated LP. This is LP. Converting it into series or parallel does not going to vary the value of L. You all agree with me? This is an equivalent circuit. So converting it into series or parallel will not change the value of L. So this is LP. Now what is left out I need to find out? I need to find out CP value. CP value is what? CP is equal to 1 by omega naught squared LP. CP is equal to 1 by omega naught squared LP. This is what we will have to do. These are the 5 steps that are involved in calculating or designing an impedance matching circuit. 5 steps involved in designing an impedance matching circuit. Can we solve this? Say yes or no? Yes. Let's do it. Make a note of this. Make a note of this. சரியா 50 ஓம்ஸ் டு 200 ஓம்ஸ்னா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து என்ன நீங்க செலக்ட் பண்ணனும் CL செலக்ட் பண்ணனும் சரியா இந்த மாடல்ல 50 போடுறோம் இந்த இது வந்து என்ன 50 ஓம்ஸ் இந்த சைடு என்னவா இருக்கும் 200 ஓம்ஸ் இது ஓகே தானா சரியா சப்போஸ் 200 டு 50 ஓம்ஸ் கன்வர்ஷன் நான் கொடுக்கறேன்னு வெச்சுக்கோ இந்த இடத்துல 200 போட்டுருவா இந்த இடத்துல 50 போட்டுருவா இந்த இடத்துல 200 போட்டுருவா இந்த இடத்துல 50 போட்டுருவா அது வரைக்கும் ஓகே தானா சரியா சோ எந்த சைடு கன்வர்ஷன் 200 ஓம்ஸ் 50 ஓம்ஸ் கன்வர்ஷன் இந்த இடத்துல 50 ஓம்ஸ் இருக்கும் இஸ் ஓகே நவ இந்த நெட்வொர்க்ல பாரு இது ரெண்டும் என்னவா இருக்கு ரைட் சைடு மட்டும் பாரு இந்த ரெண்டு போட்டோஸ் என்னவா இருக்கு சீரிஸ்ல இருக்கா பேரலல் இருக்கா சீரிஸ்ல இருக்கு சோ ஆர்எஸ் என்ன 50 ஓம்ஸ் அப்ப இன்னொரு போட்டோ என்ன ஆர்பி ஆர்பி என்ன இருக்கும் சரியா அது நீங்க அனாலிசிஸ் எல்லாம் பண்ணீங்கன்னா கன்ஃபியூஸ் ஆயிடும் லெட்ஸ் நாட் டு தட் சரியா இந்த இடத்துல ரொம்ப சிம்பிளா பாரு இது ரெண்டும் என்னவா இருக்கு சீரிஸ் இருக்கு சோ ஆர்எஸ் will be 50 ஓம்ஸ் சார்ஜிங் சர்க்யூட் to match oh 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source at 2.4 gigahertz at 2.4 gigahertz which can you do it yes or no right now what is the 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source now listen here
downward
is it upward transformation or downward transformation
downward
transformation right downward transformation when your dad comes to know about your love what happens when your dad comes to know about your love what happens chapels will fly right chapels will fly so whenever you use downward transformation you will use which circuit LC circuit use LC circuit remember that right so can we do the step one right so first is L C right and I have my impedance and I have my impedance this is my L and this is my C this is L C and what is this guy What is this gain? What is the value of this gain?
50 ohms. 50 ohms.
50 ohms. 200. 200 ohms, right? You are converting 200 ohms only to 50 ohms. Is it not? Yes or not? So this is 200. What is this fellow? What is this gain? This guy is 50 ohms. This guy is 50 ohms. This is my step 1. Am I right? What is step 2? What is step 2? Identify RP and RS. What is step 2? Find out RP and RS. Can someone tell me these two products are they connected in series or they are connected in parallel? They are connected in parallel. So what is RP?
200 ohms.
200 ohms. And what will be RS?
50 ohms.
50 ohms. RS will be 50 ohms. Hey, sir, no doubt. So what is Q? Root of RP by RS minus 1. So what is the value?
1.73.
What is it? Root of
3.
RP is what?
200
by 50 minus 1. Root 3. Root 3. Is it okay? This is step 2. What is the step 3? Step 3 is what? What is step 3? Convert into
series circuit.
In that case, you had a parallel circuit. So you converted. I'm sorry. In that case, you had a series circuit. So you converted into parallel. Here, what do you have?
Parallel
circuit. So what should you convert?
Series.
Convert it into series. So I draw that circuit. LS, CS, and this is here. 200 ohms. This is your 200 ohms. What do we need to find? We need to find CS. We need to find CS. What is the Q factor for a series circuit? What is the Q of a series circuit?
1 by omega naught CS.
Q of a series circuit is what? Q is equal to
1
over omega naught
CS
RS. We have 1 over omega naught CS RS. Yes or no? Right. So I have the call defect to Q. I have omega naught 2 pi f. Omega naught is what? 2 pi f. What is f? 2.4 into 10 power 9. I need Cs. So Cs is equal to 1 over omega naught Q Rs. Tell me what is Cs. Tell me what is Cs. Points on? All of you getting it? Points on picofarad? You getting it? Points on picofarad? Dude. You said calculators. Wait, you're getting it?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Hey, Varda. Point 0.7 picofarad. You getting it? Guys, you're getting it points on pick up current? Hey, yes sir, no doubt.
Yes sir.
Yes? Can you go out? So this is 0.7 picofarad. 0.7 picofarad. Finish, all of you. Can you go out? Yes or no?
Yes.
So what is the next step? What is the next step? What is step 4? What is step 4, huh? Convert the original circuit. So what do you do at LR? LS. And we need to find out what? LS. We need to find out what? LS. What is LS? LS is equal to 1 over
omega
naught
squared
Cs. 1 over omega naught squared Cs. Tell me what is LS? 0.63 microhundred. Come to a conclusion. 0.63? 6 point?
5.7
into 10 power minus 9, right? Into 10 power minus 9. So this will be 6.28 nanometers. Okay, you're getting it? So this is step 5. So how does your impedance matching circuit look like? Sorry. This is 6.28 nanometers, and what is this gain? What is Cs?
0.7.
This is your impedance matching circuit. This is your impedance matching circuit. Your LC impedance matching circuit. Yes? Matching circuit to match a 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source. 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source at 2.4 gigahertz. At 2.4 gigahertz. Guys, can you do it? Hey, sir, no, right. Now, what is the 200 ohms load to 50 ohms source? Now, listen here.
Downward.
Is it upward transformation or downward transformation?
Downward.
Downward transformation, right? downward transformation. When your dad comes to know about your love, what happens? When your dad comes to know about your love, what happens? Chappals will fly. Right? Chappals will fly. So whenever you use downward transformation, you use which circuit? LC circuit. Use LC circuit. Remember that. Right, so can we do the step one? Right. So first is L C. Right? And I have my impedance. And I have my impedance. This is my L and this is my C. This is L C. And what is this guy? What is this guy? What is the value of this guy?
50 ohms.
200 ohms, right? You are converting 200 ohms only to 50 ohms. Is it not? Yes or not? So this is 200. What is this fellow? What is this guy? This guy is 50 ohms. This guy is 50 ohms. This is my step 1. Am I right? What is step 2? What is step 2? Identify RP and RS. What is step 2? Find out RP and RS. Can someone tell me these two products, are they connected in series, are they connected in parallel? They are connected in parallel. So what is RP?
200 ohms.
And what will be RS?
50 ohms.
50 ohms. RS will be 50 ohms. Hey, yes or no? So what is Q? Root of RP by RS minus 1. So what is the value?
1.73.
What is it? Root of?
3.
RP is what? 200? 200 by 50 minus 1. Root? 3. Root? 3. Is it okay? This is step 2. What is the step 3? Step 3 is what? What is step 3? Convert it into parallel circuit. So what should you convert?
Series.
Convert it into series. So I draw that circuit. LS, CS, and this is your 200 ohms. This is your 200 ohms. What do we need to find? We need to find CS. We need to find CS. What is the Q factor for a series circuit? What is the Q of a series circuit?
1 by omega naught CS.
Q of a series circuit is what? Q is equal to
1 over omega naught CS RS.
We have 1 over omega naught CS RS. Yes or no? Right. So I have the quality factor Q. I have omega naught 2 by F. Omega naught is what? 2 by F. What is F?
2.4
into 10 power 9. I need CS. So CS is equal to 1 over omega naught Q RS. Tell me what is CS. Points on? All of you getting it? Points on picofarad? You're getting it? Points on picofarad? Dude. Use your calculators. Wait, you're getting it?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Hey, Varda. Point 0.7 picofarad. You getting it? Can you go out? So this is 0.7 picofarad. 0.7 picofarad. Finished, all of you. Can we go? Yes or no?
Yes.
So, what is the next step? What is the next step? What is step 4? What is step 4, huh? Convert the original circuit. So, what do you do at LR? LS. And we need to find out what? LS. We need to find out what? LS. What is LS? LS is equal to 1 over
omega
naught squared CS. 1 over omega naught squared CS. Tell me what is LS? 0.63 microhenry. Come to a conclusion.
6.28
into 10 power minus 9, right? Into 10 power minus 9. So this will be 6.28 nanometer. Okay, you're getting it? So this is step 5. So how does your impedance matching circuit look like? Sorry. This is 6.28 nanometer, and what is this gate? What is the S?
0.7.
This is your impedance matching circuit. This is your impedance matching circuit. Your LC impedance matching circuit. Yes?